that before. I've been hearing that these guys can't guard me better than anybody else, so I just have to come out there and show that I'm the most unstoppable player in the league.
Joel Embiid, in my opinion, the best center in all of the NBA today. This guy, he's got phenomenal footwork. He's great around the rim. He can throw it down. He can put it on the floor. He can dribble. He can do the pick and roll perfectly. He's able to pick and pop. He can literally do everything with phenomenal defense, blocking shots. In my opinion, if he can stay healthy, he could be one of the best centers to ever play in the NBA. Today, we're going to look at some of his animations on 2K. We want to see if they are as dominant as they are in the NBA as they are on 2K. You can see right here, he's going to showcase some of his animations, going down, bumping, doing the fadeaway. Like I said, in these series, I've done a lot of them. You guys seem to really enjoy it. So we're going to try to play as much as we can as the actual NBA player. You can see right here, like I said, Joel Embiid, he can face up, shoot that mid-range jump shot. One of the best centers to do everything in the NBA. Catch and shoot right away to the fadeaway. He can face you up, give you the, put it on the floor, give you the dribble, and dunk the ball. So let's go ahead and see if Joel Embiid's animations are really this dominant. All right, guys, so today we'll be looking at Joel Embiid. We're going to be using my shot post for this video. He's 7 foot, Joel Embiid 7 foot, so I think this encompasses Joel Embiid's complete game the most. But let's go ahead and look at some of his animations. You guys can see right here, he is using Zach LaVine's jump shot. So we will be using Zach LaVine on this. Well, hopefully it's pretty good. You can see, like I said, Joel Embiid, he can put the ball on the floor. He can lay it up. He can dunk with some of the best of them. But these are the animations that he uses on 2K. You know, some of his athletic dunks aren't on here, so we might throw in a couple of those as well. But this is where it gets interesting. This is his animations for his fadeaways and his post games. If you guys watched the clips beforehand, Fade 9 looks exactly like the fade that he uses in real life, so we will be using Fade 9. Now, if you guys have been with me since 2K18, you guys know I hate post-hop shot 3. It's one of the worst post-hop shots in the game, but we will try to use this, see if we can get some greens with that. Now, the shimmy fade. The dream shake, I believe, is Fade 8. He's pretty good at the shimmy, I'm not going to lie to you, so we're going to have to try to use this a few times. Hopefully, we can get a few people with it, so we will be using shimmy Fade 8. Now, when it comes to his ball handling, you guys know Joel Embiid, for a big man that's 7 foot, he's great with dribbling. He can put the ball on the floor, cross people over, and dunk the ball. So we're going to go ahead and use my regular animations when it comes to dribbling, because he's a good dribbler, and you guys know my shot post, he can dribble with the best of them. But yeah, guys, that's going to be it. I hope you do enjoy the video. If you want to see any other NBA player, any NBA player at all, past or present, let me know in the comment section. I will get it done. But I hope you guys do enjoy the video. Let's go ahead and get right into the park games. All right, guys, so we're finally back at the park. You can see we've got the throwback Joel Embiid jersey. We're on my shot post, 7 foot, and we're going to dominate. Now, if you guys want to see me play with my actual post score animations, go check me out. First link in the description. We go live on Twitch. A lot of the times we go live, we're going on the post score. We're playing in the stage. You know, we're just dominating. But you can see the first play of the game, we're going with the up and under. Nice post move right there. We're going up 2-0. Post hop shot 3, he jumps. Too far away, we're knocking it down. We're up by 4. Now, like I said, in these videos, I try to play my best, just like the NBA player actually does. I don't want to speed boost. I don't want to play like 2K. I'm going to try to do what Joel Embiid actually does in real life. You can see quick Euro. He's too short. We're making an open shot, up 6-0. Now, if you want to see a different NBA player, post scores, anything like that, let me know in the comment section. I do have a lot of jerseys. I want to test out some new animations because that's what makes this series most enjoyable. You can see a little body in the paint. We're going up with the post hook. Easy shot again, 8-0. Now, I really do showcase in this gameplay how unstoppable Joel Embiid is, because like I had mentioned, I really do believe he is the most unstoppable center at when healthy in the NBA, because he can do so much. Like I had mentioned, gets you in the post, he can shoot the three, he can shoot the mid-range, plays great defense, the pick and roll, the pick and pop. Like, he just does everything very well. So you can see, again, he's leaving me wide open. He thinks I can't shoot, but to be honest with you, I would leave me open too, especially with this jumper, because it was horrendous. Throwing it behind the back, I have park dunks on by accident. I know Joel Embiid doesn't really do those dunks, but he does do some crazy dunks. I know you guys remember him throwing down windmills and all that kind of stuff. Again, leaving me open. It's not green. Zach LaVine's jumper, I don't know if his footing is just a little bit weird, but our foot's on the line, so it's not a three. But again, like I mentioned, we're not missing any of the shots, so we're going to go ahead and give him the up and under again. I step to the side, give him the green. I'm patient. I'm not just forcing up shots. I know what I'm doing in the post. Going to be patient, and we're able to score again. 18 points, 9 for 9 at this point. I wanted to shoot the limitless three, but I also didn't want to miss, but he baits on the pump fake. I'm throwing it behind my back again. I wanted a Euro step dunk, but we'll take that. 10 for 10, haven't missed a shot. Now, this is going to be the last play of this game. Vinny Bull is going to hit me up. I want to do something cool. I'm going to go in the post, switch my position, step it back, go back in the post, give him the shimmy fade. Shimmy fade 8. We're greening it, and that's going to be the first gameplay, 11 for 11. Now, we're going to go ahead and hop in straight into this second game. You can see, I think we're going against the post score right here. We're finally going to get this stop. I get the rebound and we're going out. Now it's time to dominate. Now I do miss a few times in this gameplay right here. You can see we're going right back in the post. This guy was 7-3 and I believe he was a pure post scorer. You can see he's playing pretty good defense to start off the game. So I know I have to go in my bag a little bit more. Try to draw him out because I am a lot faster than him. You can see I get him with this crossover. Spin back out. Hit him with the green fade. And we're greening that shot. Now with this fadeaway right here, it was pretty bad to the left. You can see it was pretty slow. If you can get room, you can time it very easily. But this fadeaway to the right, which I think I will showcase here in a minute, was amazing. Look at that nice crossover fade to the right, like I mentioned, really quick, 4-0. Nice little sequence of animations. We're going with the post hop shot 3. You can see it creates zero space. It's hard to time. He kicks it out. Vinny Bulli getting that rebound. We're throwing it down. Now, I've got this gameplay, one more. I want to show you guys the highlights of these. If you want to see more gameplays in the future, I did have a few more, but I just wanted to kind of condense it down to the best ones, in my opinion, where I do the most, you know, different animations. See post-hop shot 3. That's like the only good post-hop shot animation right there with post-hop shot 3. We're going to go ahead, bring it back out, spin it again, fade away to the right, not green, still dropping down. Those post scores that are 7-3, guys, if they're ever getting guarded by one of them and you're a center, draw them out. You're a lot quicker if you've got a build like I do. You can see I could have easily spun right by him, but we're going to be patient. Hit him with a shimmy. See Vinny Bulli cut. I'm lobbing it to him. Joel Embiid's got that passing vision. 14-6 game. Now, again, we're bringing him down into the paint. He's not really expecting me to do any of those moves out there. You can see I'm missing that shot. It's wide open, so I'll take that. Finally get a green with Zach LaVine's jumper. Up 16-6. Like I said, I'm going to bring him all the way out. I could have easily euroed him. I'm pretty much just crabbing him at this point. He's jumping like crazy. Post-hop shot 3. Zero space created, but just enough to get that shot off to put us up by 12. One of these possessions, again, I'm going to actually go down right into the paint. I don't know. That's a tough shot. Relentless finisher. You know, it was a heavily contested shot, but we're still knocking it down. But this play of the game shows exactly how being patient as a post scorer actually benefits you. Look how many times I kicked this out. Hit him with the Euro step. He could have easily blocked that if I went in for a regular layup or dunk. But the Euro step was a smart decision right there. And we're actually able to make that shot. But this is going to be the last gameplay. You can see they got the ball right here. They're going against a guy named Delayed Wins. He's a pure shot creator, I do believe. He misses that shot, and that's where he messes up. You can't miss a shot and give me the ball. Because, again, I think this gameplay, I do shoot perfect as well. I think it went 10 for 10. You can see first shot of the game. It doesn't go – it's not green, but it's still going down. We're able to make that. I'm going to kick it out again. Give him a quick crossover. Go right back into the post. Fade away to the right side. That fade away to the right, like I said, it's not that good, but it's easy to time, and it's pretty quick. So you can see this guy's playing actually pretty decent defense. I'll give it to him. I try to lob Vinny Bulli again. He kicks it right back out. I couldn't get any greens with this jumper. A lot of these shots weren't going down for me for the green, but you can see in the top right, we're shooting 100% with his animations. At this point, I believe they're talking about trying to switch it because this guy was not able to play very well defense on me. I'm going to kick it a Vinny Bulli. He sees me wide open, like in the paint. That's pretty much, I think, a close shot. We're able to knock that down. You can see 9 points, shooting 100%. Now we're up 9-2. Look, right here, they try to switch. I think they're trying to double-team me, but it's not going to work because I got Vinny Bulli as a stretch in the corner. I'm going to dot him. He's going to dunk it, and we're going up again. Again, guys, if you guys do want to follow me on Twitter, I usually do run with subs or something when this happens, when I'm trying to get gameplays like these. So if you want to run with me, always, you know, I always tweet off stuff like that. So go follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Twitch if you want to see gameplay as well. 13-2, nice little drop step, heavily contested. It doesn't matter, man. We're still knocking it down. Now, if you guys are this far into the video, I want you to go to the comment section right now. Say 50K on the way. My goal is to hit 50K before this month is over. I know I can do it. I'm going to try to upload as much as I can, but I want to upload all the videos you guys want to see, all the builds, all the archetypes, all the ideas. Drop them in the comment section as well. We're going to try to go crazy this month because, like I mentioned, this summer is going to be insane. So we're up 15-2. We're going to go ahead and give him the drop step. Kick it back out. We're patient. We're going right back in the post. You can see he's jumping like crazy. I'm able to put it up because takeover is so overpowered. That's only a light contest with a big man down low. I'll take it though because he's just spamming the up stick. So we're going to be patient and do our own thing. He's leaving me wide open at this point. Going to give him the quick crossover. I want to go into the post because I'm not trying to force the ball and shoot a bad shot. Going to give him the fade right there. 19-2. we're pretty much unstoppable. 17 points on 100% shooting, man. Joel Embiid's animations, they weren't the best, but when you play smart, you can pretty much make all your shots. Like I mentioned, I'm 8-for-8, actually. I forgot Venue Bully actually did make a shot. 19-2. This is going to be the last play of the game. Again, like I had mentioned, guys, if you want to see more videos like this, drop the players, drop the archetypes, and I will get it done for you. Last play of the game, we're going to be patient. They try to throw this guard on me in the last play, but it's way too late. I could have honestly shot that shot. I want to get a shimmy in there, but we're going to get the ball back top of the key, give him a quick step back hezzy. Guards can't even guard me, can't contest the shot. Easy dunk for the game. Thank you guys for all the support, but I've been Dignified. I'm out. Peace.